Jesus Christ through a game of chess. Are you aware of the game of chess?
Yes.
Are you aware of the rules that I move, then you can move?
Yes.
And then if I move, then you can move.
Okay.
Right. But this day I want to move. Want to do that?
Nope. Because there's rules.
There are rules, and as there are rules in a game of chess, our loving Father has rules for how we live. Right. What if I really, really wanted to do? Just to do it?
No.
Why not? Because that's not the rules. There are rules to live by. Okay. So. The rules are, I move, you move. And it's the very same with God. He moves, we move. See, we have all sinned because of the very first star of man, which was Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. They were given all the trees to eat in the garden. God's only request was that they not eat the tree of good and evil. Alongside the tree of good and evil was the tree of life. But there came a day when the lowliest creature, the sneakiest snake, came along and said to Eve, did God really say? Putting doubt in Eve's mind. And once the doubt had been planted, the more she looked at that tree, the more luscious the fruit looked. So she went across and quickly took fruit and bit into it. But God had said that they would surely die if they did this, but she did not die. So she handed it to their husband, their mate, Adam. But when God saw what had happened, he could not allow them to eat from the tree of life, because that meant that they would be in that state forever. So he banned them from the garden for their own sake. Now we have moved away from God through Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve had children who killed, who sinned, who lied, and that, like a stream, is passed down to us. The stream does not go up a mountain, it comes down. But God had a plan. And because now we've become close to God, he needed a way to open up to him. And that way was through his son, Jesus Christ, that he sent over 2,000 years ago. Now Jesus, his baptism, was filled with the Holy Spirit and totally open to God. And today we are given that opportunity. We are given the opportunity to repent of our sins, face God, and with that comes the baptism of the Holy Spirit through repentance and belief. Now, as you can see, we don't get a smaller measure of the Holy Spirit. We get the exact measure that Jesus has. So, as disciples, which are apprentices of Jesus, we get to do as Jesus did. We get to touch people's lives. We get to heal the sick. We get to pray for people. We get to sow seeds. Telling people about Jesus in the kingdom of God so they can